Friends, I thought it may be useful for me to share what I learned firsthand about this COVID treatment at our college hostel, which has been converted into a COVID ward by the Madurai District Administration in the last 15 days. There are about 250 plus patients inside. Most of them are not very sick. These 250 people are positive, and the whole facility is being managed by two medical officers and a team of four or five nursing assistants. And they are being catered food by an outside caterer. I find that 90% of the patients are with mild fever between 99 and 100 and are seen moving about most of the time. If a patient becomes very sick, if the temperature goes above 101, then the medical officer administers paracetamol to him. Otherwise, he's given a packet of multivitamins each morning. And they give Kabasura Kudineer. And if very acute symptoms surface, like breathing distress, they are taken to the general hospital. So far, we have only seen one such case amongst 250 or 260 in the last 12 days. And in the last 12 days, the first batch of people who came, about 60 of them, have been discharged yesterday. So the point to understand here is, for a normal, healthy person, irrespective of the age, this is only a flu and more a self-regulating flu. It comes and goes. Problems come only when there are other comorbidities like acute asthma or uncontrolled diabetics or some other ailments that complicates matters. You can imagine the kind of care which the government doctors give, and that too, two doctors giving care for 250 people. So if someone is capable of taking care of himself, he can do it at home as well. So I think it's not, though it's an epidemic, it is spreading fast, but a net effect, it's not a killer disease as it's being projected by the media. And it can be managed very well by a person of normal capability and intelligence. The medical officer also told me that most of these people come from some very humble backgrounds. They're all Aam Aadmis. Therefore, the nutrition levels, he said, has been very poor historically. And on top of this poor nutrition, they are addicted to liquor. And he says that's what complicates matters in this category of people. And he says that's a fact which they are not able to speak out. Thank you.